In this video, I will cover how to convert special units like these on the board here into the base unit equivalent. So in physics, we use special units like Newton, Pascal, Joule, and so on to save us having to write down a whole load of base units from the SI system. So I've got five here, and next to them I've got the equation that I'll use to work out the base unit equivalent for each of those units. We'll start with the Newton. F equals ma is the equation I'll use to work out the base unit equivalent. So force is measured in newtons, and mass is measured in kilograms. Acceleration is measured in meters per second squared. So kilograms times meters per second squared. We can't simplify that any further. They are already the base unit. So kilogram is the base unit for mass in the SI system. M is the base unit for length, and S is the base unit for time. So that's now kilogram meters per second squared is already in base units for us. So that's very straightforward. What I did there is I replaced the quantities with the corresponding unit, then multiplied them all out. There wasn't any simplification to be done or any replacement substitution, so it was a very straightforward example there. Let's now go to Pascal. Pressure is measured in pascals. Force is measured in newtons. And area is in meters squared. Now, we've just found out what we can substitute for the Newton with the base units, or the base unit equivalent. So we've got kilogram meters per second squared there. So I've got kilogram meters per second squared divided by meters squared. Now I've got meters on the top row, meters squared on the bottom row, so I can simplify that. So now I've got kilograms per meter per second squared by simplifying that. And that's the Pascal. Now we'll go to the joule. Work done is force times the distance moved in the direction of the force. So the joule for work done, force is measured in newtons, multiplied by distance in meters. So I can again use what I have worked out for the Newton in base units here, kilogram meters per second squared times by meters. I can simplify that again. I've got meters squared here, so kilograms meters squared per second squared. So we've done the joule. Now we'll move to the watt. Watt is work done per unit time. So, power is work done per unit time. So the watt is joule per second. I've got the equivalent for joules in base units here, so I can now replace the joule with that. So I've got kilogram meters squared per second squared divided by seconds. I can simplify the second term, so that'll be seconds to the minus 3. And that's the watts done. That's the watt. Last one, hertz. So F is measured in hertz. 1 is a constant, it doesn't have any units, so it's 1 over seconds, so that's just seconds to the minus 1. And that is how you convert these special units that we use in physics into the base units for the SI system.